Hello, welcome to Inkdrop, a markdown note-taking app for software developers. Thank you for downloading. My name is Takuya, the author of Inkdrop from Japan. It's a pleasure to meet you. And here's my companion. His name is Inu-san, who is going to learn how to use Inkdrop with you. Hey, can you introduce yourself?
Sure. Hello, my name is Inu-san. I'm an aspiring software developer and can't wait to learn Inkdrop to improve my workflow.
Great. Let's get right into it. First, let's explore the main user interface. The Inkdrop interface is divided into three main sections. The leftmost section is the sidebar, which has menus like all notes, displaying all the notes you have, along with notebooks, note statuses, and tags. The middle section is the note list. It includes a search bar, and there are a button for changing the note order, and a button to create a new note.
Whoa, there are so many features to learn.
Don't worry. We won't dive deeper into them just yet. You don't need to understand everything to start tech note-taking. Now, let's select a notebook and create a new note. You can click this button, but you also have the option to press Command N on macOS or Control N on Windows and Linux to quickly create a new note in the selected notebook. Then, a new note will appear in the rightmost section, which is the editor. After you press Enter, the focus will move to the tag input bar. Let's add tags like Markdown and Tips, and press Enter again. Now it's ready to start taking notes.
Okay, but I remember that you said Inkdrop is a Markdown note-taking app. What does it mean?
Good point. Inkdrop is a Markdown note-taking app, which means that the app comes with a Markdown editor. So it's important to understand what Markdown is.
Is it a language or something like that?
Right. Markdown is a lightweight markup language that uses special syntax to format text. It's easy to learn and use. Let me write some text.
Okay, but I can't memorize all these syntaxes right away.
No worries. There's a toolbar located above that editor for that. You can use it to format your text easily. When you hover a toolbar button, it displays the keyboard shortcut associated with that formatting option like so.
Great. I'll gradually become accustomed to using them.
Awesome. Let's insert a list. Now, let's check out what it looks like in the rendered preview by pressing Command E on macOS or Control E on Linux and in Windows.
What happened?
What you are seeing now is the HTML rendering of your Markdown note. As mentioned earlier, Markdown is a lightweight markup language. It can be converted into HTML, making your content viewable almost anywhere. Additionally, you can press Command P on macOS or Control P on Windows and Linux to toggle the side-by-side mode. In this mode, the HTML rendering pane appears on the right side of the editor.
Oh, nice! So I don't have to switch between view modes frequently. Well, I have a question. Can I use Markdown on other websites?
Yes, you can. And that's one of the key reasons to learn Markdown. It is widely used across various platforms and websites. such as GitHub. It uses Markdown for README files, comments, and documentation. Slack and Discord, popular chat messages apps, allow you to format messages with Markdown. And Discourse, it's a popular forum software, adopts Markdown for its posts and comments. And also, many static site generators like DocuZaurus, Jekyll, and Gatsby use Markdown as their primary content format.
Wow, that's incredibly versatile. I had no idea Markdown was so widely used. This definitely motivates me to master it for my projects, communication, and tech note-taking. Can you tell me why it is widely adopted by software developers?
That's a good question. Let me show you why Markdown is so useful for tech note-taking. So, software developers love Markdown not only because of its simplicity, but also because of its advanced formatting features. Inu-san, have you ever heard about GitHub-flavored Markdown?
No, I haven't. What's the difference from standard Markdown?
This is a superset of Markdown. So it includes all the features Markdown and adds a few more to meet day-to-day needs of developers. Let me demonstrate them. With GitHub-flavored Markdown, or GFM for short, you can easily insert code blocks by wrapping them with three backticks. So let's create another node. Press Command N or Control N. Let's title it like fix a bug. Now, let's say you want to take a note about your code. Then you can write Markdown like so. So if you have a JavaScript code, you can write it like this. You can also specify a specific programming language for correct syntax highlighting. Or if you have a Python code, it's gonna look like so. Let's press Command E or Control E to check out what it looks like in the HTML rendering view.
Yeah, it looks useful. I will need to copy and paste a lot of code snippets into my notes while learning. And the syntax highlighting feature would make them easy to read.
Right. Code blocks are one of the most frequently used features of GitHub-flavored Markdown. There is another useful feature you should try. That is Tasklists. GFM lets you easily track to-dos using checkboxes. Let's try it. I'm gonna create a list and add square brackets like this. If you've finished the task, you can check the box by inserting X like this. Let's press Command P or Control P to check out the preview. Boom! They are rendered as a to-do list.
Can I click these checkboxes with mouse?
Yes, you can update your to-do list on the preview pane by clicking them.
That sounds handy. What kind of tasks do you write in your notes, Takuya?
I often write checklists like libraries to try out, similar to this note titled React Native Promising Libraries. Or when adding a new feature, I create a checklist for testing, like the one titled Support Deep Link.
Thanks. I'll try using it when researching modules.
Yeah. Yeah. So it looks powerful yet simple, right? The essence of Inkdrop is to provide a seamless note-taking experience, and Markdown plays a crucial role in it. As you get comfortable with Inkdrop and Markdown, you'll realize the power of the duo. It lets you jot down thoughts, code snippets, to-do lists, and more. And more in no time and with minimal effort.
Yeah. And as I progress in my software development journey, mastering Markdown becomes an invaluable skill.
Absolutely. Even if you are not venturing into software, the sheer convenience of Markdown will enhance your digital note-taking endeavors. So that's it. Thank you for watching. Happy writing, and see you in the next session.